153 days ago, I built this ecosystem, with prey and predators coexisting in a delicate balance. I decided not to interfere, but to let nature unfold. However, when a new predator emerged, chaos ensued, and the once thriving habitat spiraled into decline. But now it's over, so we are gonna dive into the tank to check if someone has managed to survive. I made the setup with the species from my area, to enjoy nature from the comfort of my home. At the beginning, there was little more than snails and small arthropods. But with wild animals choosing to move to my ecosystem on their own, I had to introduce water scorpions as predators to control their populations. And for the first 100 days, everything worked perfectly. The ecosystem experienced a flourish phase. The number of snails increased rapidly. The plants also reproduced and grew in size. Every time I checked the aquarium, I found new creatures I didn't introduce. Even a jumping spider decided to make it its home. This is the third and probably last video on this ecosystem. We already covered the stabilization and climax stages. And now, we are about to get into the decline phase. Because everything that goes up must come down. And one day, I found inside the animal that was about to change everything forever. This poor snail was being eaten alive by this thing. This leech must have been hiding inside the tank since the first day, because when I saw it for the first time, it was already a full-grown adult. And even worse, it was taking care of a handful of babies. Here you can see how it wraps its body around a snail, sharing it with the small leeches it had attached to its belly. Even though I found extremely interesting the fact that such a small animal was looking after its offspring, it was very bad news. I knew I had to do something to save the snails. But I couldn't save them all. There were too many, and some of them were smaller than a grain of salt. So I separated a few into a new aquarium. Without predators, they can take over it peacefully. Which is a lot, considering their siblings were not having peace at all. The war was started, and none of the aquatic animals were ready to fight the leech invasion that was about to happen. I decided to take out the last water scorpion, and I left the ecosystem outside, set to forget. I checked on it a few more times, just to find the number of leeches was increasing, and the snails were harder to spot as the days went by. Without them, there was nothing left to control the plants, which quickly grew out of the tank. But then, the autumn came, and with it, the rains. The ecosystem got completely flooded, and the land plants ended up drowning. The flowering duckweeds spilled out of the tank. The aquarium was transformed into a submerged world, the void of the vibrant life that once teemed within. I couldn't find anything alive, not even the leeches. It seems they were not good at managing the food. Only the water plants were still alive, silent witnesses of the rise and fall of my small ecosystem. Today, I'm checking on it for the last time before taking it apart, and to my surprise, I found a few ostracods and copepods swimming, and on top of a leaf, a baby snail was gliding calmly, the new king, oblivious to the struggle that in the past devastated its recently claimed domains. While there's still a long journey ahead, I remain confident that the ecosystem possesses all the necessary elements to reclaim the splendor it once held in the past. Click here if you want to watch this ecosystem on its peak.